Good evening all. Today I'm going to do a short video on the Baofeng DM 1701 DMR radio. I've been playing around with it for a little week. I'm still working on the DMR side of things, but today is a video on the A and B channels, the scan lists, zones, and groups. Now I'm going to make it brief, and hopefully it'll help you understand exactly how they work. Because the A and B channels, for a start, on the dual band analogues, you can usually put like one channel in one of them, another channel in the other one, and flick between them so you can monitor both channels. And the DMR takes it to a slightly different level because they use them more when you start talking about the digital channels. But it's also good to use on the analog channels as well. So anyway, I'm going to fire up the software. I'm going to turn the radio on, which already has its programming cable in. Oops. Okay, as you see, I've already got some channels programmed into it. So the first thing I do is I'm going to read from the radio, first of all. So let's just read from the radio. Okay, it's reading. Okay, got data read successful. These are a bit of information. But the bits we're concentrating on this time is zones, scan lists, channel information. So first of all, let's go and have a look at the zones. So you can have a multitude of zones. All you do is you right click on here and click you want to add a new zone. As you see, I have two zones in here at the moment. I've also, you may have noticed, I've added a few more channels as well. But let's go and have, first of all, let's have a look at the home zone. It's set up in here. And you can see we have it's grouped into channel member A, channel member B, available channels, and available channels. So A is basically, I'll probably get some sort of animation on here, but it is the top one, which currently says emergency, which is the, it's just on the emergency channel at the moment. And the B channel, B, this bit, is where you can see GMRS channel 1 at the moment. Now, the difference in this is that you can tell it which channels are allowed to show in either the top one or the bottom one. Now, you can see that in channel member A, currently on the emergency one, I have the 2 meter call, 70 centimeters, a local repeater, my club repeater, a couple of other repeaters. Now, I'm not going to go into these. These will be done on a different video. These are the digital things which I'm slowly working out. And you will then notice that on the channel B, they have all the GMRS or GMRS FRS channels. Now, what that means is, if you go to the radio and we're currently on, as you can see, we're on the emergency one at the minute, and I switch it through. You can see 2 meter call, 70 centimeters, repeater, blah, 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 blah. If I keep going, some of the ones I'm not talking about today, and it goes back to emergency. Okay, now if I put it onto the other one, where it's on the GMRS, oops, wrong one, you'll see you got 2, 3, 4, 5, and it'll just keep 10, 12, 14, 15, and then back to 1. So it basically means that you can put as many or as little channels in each group in member A or member B. So as you can see on mine, I've got my member B group set as all the GMRS. GMRS channels, and all the ones in number A, sorry, number, letter A, I have all the, well, also not all the repeaters, but all the local repeaters in my home zone. Now that means this is the area where I can pick up when I'm at home. Now you'll then notice if I move on to the next one, it's got one of two, now it's got two of two. This is my work zone. So I did this one slight to make it look slightly different. And you can see that I kept the B range the same. So it's GMRS 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, all the way through to 15. But I've only put the emergency, the 2 meter call, and the 70 centimeters in my home, in my work zone. So if I go to the radio and I go to the menu and then have a look at, menu and go down to zone and menu again. I set the zone lists and currently it's set at home zone. So I'm going to drop it down, I'm going to put it into work zone, I'm going to turn work zone on. Okay, so it's now in work zone, and in the bottom you can see work zone. So, down the DMRS here, so which is the B channel, let's flick through that, it's 1 through to 15 again. So I kept that channel, I kept that the same way, but if I go to the top one, which is the A channel, you can see if I scroll through them, so the emergency 2 meter call, and it's back to emergency again. So it's only showing those ones because they are the only ones available in home zone. Well, that makes sense. So I'm going to change it back. I'm going to put it back into zone list. Switch it to the home zone and put it back and then turn it on. So back into the home zone. So if I flick through this again, we now go through all the different zones that I have set up for home. That is how that works, the A and B channel members. In the zones, in the home zones. The next thing is scan lists. Now if we go back to the computer here, if we click on scan list A, I've called it scan A. It basically means scan, for my purposes, scan analog. So it's all the analog channels I've got programmed in the minute, which is not many. So you can see that I haven't put any of these ones in. I don't want scan A, any of these ones, I just don't want them. There's digitals and there's GMRS in there. And you can set the priority channel where it checks this channel more than it, when it flicks through the all these, it actually checks this one. I think it checks it three times as many as the other one. I don't quote me on that, I'm still trying to work that one out. And the priority channel 2 is the second priority, which is my club channel here. And the TX designated channel is the last active channel. I'll go over that in a moment. That's how you set up a scan list. However, just setting up this scan list by itself like this, it's not going to work. If I go into the scan channels, if I hadn't configured it all correctly, if I go into scan and I select scan A, nothing would happen on the radio. Now I couldn't work out exactly, I couldn't see anything in the documentation about that. So I'm going to fiddle around and I noticed that if you go into the channel information for all the different channels that you've set up, if you click on, say for example, emergency, it brings up the emergency channel information. It's analog, emergency, blah, 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 12 gigahertz. Well, I think it probably puts an arrow, right, whatever. Which is 156.8, the receiving channel, and 156.8 transmission. So it's a simplex, it's emergency broadcast channel. What I did notice that this was like this by default. And even though I had it added in this list here, if you don't select it in here as well, it doesn't work. So you have to put scan A, or well, in my case, scan A, which is the group A that I've called. And if you don't put that in there, it doesn't scan. So as soon as I put this in there, the first day I tried it, it started scanning, but it would only scan one channel. So I went through to the 2 meter, I did the same, 2 meters, I did the same thing again, then the 70 centimeters, I did the same thing again, all the different repeaters I want. And I put them all on there. Now, I think those bandwidths are wrong. Anyway, I'll fix that later on. So if to get the scan list working, you have to have add your items into the scan and also add them in here, which to me seems a bit odd, but maybe it's later on down the line as I'm learning this radio will start to make sense. There must be a reason for it. So you can see I have three scan lists. I've got scan A, which is scan for analog, which does them. I have scan GMRS, so it's all I've got in here is the GMRS scanning. I haven't set any priority channels on this and the last active channel. Digital we will go into on another day. So let's go to this one, because I think this one's probably going to be more active than the GMRS. So let's go to the radio. And I go to the menu and I'm going to select scan. I'm going to view the lists. See, it's scanning on analog. So if I emergency, okay, let's go back. Oh, there we go. Oops. Now, so since it's on there, in order to do the scan, I have. Okay, I'll show you from the keyboard first. So if you go to there, push scan, turn scan on, and the it's indicating it's scanning is that little icon there. I don't know if you can see it on the radio. It's like a little circle with a little pointy arrow type thing in it. So that is now scanning. Now, I don't know if there's going to be anybody on this channel, on this thing tonight. But what happens is you don't see any movement on the screen. I don't know if that's a firmware issue or whether I programmed something wrong, but as soon as one of the channels becomes active, it switches to that channel and starts, and you can hear what's going on. And when you hear something going on, and if you want to interrupt, it's not interrupt, that's a bad thing to do. If you want to respond back on that, then all you do is you press the PTT button, the push to talk button. And what it does is it remembers the last channel that was active and broadcasts your signal on that one. So that's what that last active channel means. So if somebody was broadcasting on 2 meters and you were flicking past and all of a sudden you came onto the 2 meters, it would allow you to listen to it. And then it would, as soon as you push the PTT button, since that was the last channel active, it would then broadcast on that channel. Now, it doesn't hang around on each channel long. So I believe that's to do with the signaling hold times, I believe, which if you look on the screen here, I think it's to do with this. I haven't played around with this yet, but I think that's how long it listens to the channel for before it starts moving on and scanning the rest. Priority slamming is it listens to the priority ones a lot longer. So that's how the channel scanning works. So if I was to stop it, scan and turn off. I also have it scanned, pushed into, I have programmed into the, so you've got the different programmer buttons here, the push to, I've got it programmed into this top one here. So if I push it, you see the scan started. And if I push it again, the scan stops. So the next one is I'm going to jump it down to the channel on the GMRS. And if I push scan, it starts scanning the GMRS channels. And that'll just keep going and going. I don't think many people are going to be on GMRS at this time of night. Local people sending their kids to bed. It's a bit late. So that's how you set up the scan lists. Let's jump that back up to the, oops. So that's how you do this scan lists. And I'm just thinking what else I was going to go through with you here. What have I got here? I've got, so that's my digital ID. As I say, that's another thing I'm going to go over in a later date. So I think that was pretty much it. It was just, oh yeah, that's digital, that's all later on. So yeah, it was just showing you how the home zones, how the different zones work, and how the different A and B channels worked for the different zones and what you can do, and also the different scan lists that you can set up and go through. Remember, when you set up a scan list, you add the channel to the scan list that you want. For example, all the GMRs is here, but I haven't put these ones in here. That'd be the analogues. I put all the analogues here that I've got, but not the GMRSs. And remember, you have to put in the channel itself as the scan list, into a scan list, for it to work. So hopefully that's helping with help you with your adventures. I'm almost ready to start looking at the start doing a video on the, oh my god, sorry, it's late at night, on the DMR side. I was like, I've got my ID. I successfully connected to my local repeater in a DMR channel. I've done a test on the test channel on DMR, which is called Parrot, which comes back fine. I'm just having a couple of niggling little things on the groups. I'm still trying to work that side of it out. So anyway, I hope this has been helpful. If you guys have got any input on this, as I say, I'm learning. Maybe you guys are going to learn off me. Hopefully. Maybe I can learn off something off you guys. So anyway, it's 11:30 at night now here in Vancouver, and I got work in the morning. So have a good evening, everybody. 7-3s. Good night.